Hi, hello, and welcome to another video by the scientist formerly known as Nigelli. As you know, I always try to make innovative videos where I show new ideas and projects with soda cans. Not this time. Still, it will be some DIY project with soda cans, but I would like to revisit a project that was presented years ago on a YouTube channel called ArtMöbius. I will leave you the link to the original video in the description. As you can see on the video, it's about making a three-dimensional spherical object out of two-dimensional flattened soda can sheets. I already posted a video how to make these sheets, just follow the link in the upright corner. In addition, you need a ruler and an X-acto knife, a cardboard square and a cardboard circle, a pen and these styluses for embossing of the soda cans. As previously said, the making of such spherical object out of soda cans was already presented in another video. However, I would like to add some improvements. Especially in comparison to the original video, I would like to remove the ink from the soda cans to have the shiny side outside. I already posted a video how to remove the ink from soda cans, just follow the link in the upper right corner. However, as you can see, I put the soda can sheets first in a pressure cooker and thereafter the ink can be removed by a solvent like acetone or nail polish remover. So the process starts by cutting squares from flattened soda cans. The side length of 10 centimeters was chosen because in this way you can cut two squares out of one soda can. To complete this project, you need 6 half-liter soda cans. From these 6 soda cans, you make flattened sheets, and those sheets are cut in half to produce like 12 of these squares. 6 squares are just left as they are, and from the other 6, the ink is removed. We start with the untreated squares and mark the diagonal. Place the cardboard circle onto the sheet so that the circle is touching the diagonals. Press down the embossing stylus and move it along the circle to score the aluminum. Repeat this for all 4 sides. Now we are going to make creases manually. The aluminum will immediately go into the right position due to the strong scoring. This is now the inside piece of one unit. The next step is showing how to make the outside piece. So to make the outside piece, of course, we take the soda can squares where we have removed the ink, so the shiny part. Mark the center of all 4 sides with the use of the cardboard square. For the next step, we need again the cardboard circle. I have to say that I did reinforce the circle with glue because you need it several times. Take the circle and align it so that the circle connects 2 center marks. Press down the circle and go around the circle with the embossing pen to score the aluminum. Again, we are going to make creases by hand. The aluminum will immediately go into the right position due to the strong scoring. We finished now the outside piece of the first unit. So the next step is to combine the outside piece and the inside piece here lying next to each other to one unit. Now take the outside piece with the shiny surface and place it carefully over the inside piece. Then fold over the corners to align with the edge. Due to the aluminum, the structure will not unfold. Now you have completed one single unit. You need 5 more to form the spherical structure. with a knife, we are going to loosen a little bit the pocket from the flap, so it's more easier to fit two units together. Insert the flap of one unit into a pocket of another unit and shift it over. This process is now continued until all six units are combined and form the spherical object. And that's how the final product looks like, with the shiny part outside. In comparison, you have the one with the matte side outside. It really looks different. But we still need to make our stand to present the object. Reduce a 0.5-liter soda can to half of its size. Then punch a hole into the bottom part of the soda can with scissors. Then put some shrink tubing over a grill stick and shrink it with a lighter. Put the grill stick into the hole that you punched into the bottom part of the soda can and fix it with hot glue. Put sand and concrete together with water into a bag and mix it. Add the mixture into the form you just prepared. Let it dry overnight, and the next day remove the aluminum. Within one day, the concrete is not completely hardened, so with a piece of metal, you can easily reshape the size of your concrete stand. Take the plastic away from an alligator clip and then fix it to one end of a grill stick with glue. And then attach the spherical object to the alligator clip. And if you now proudly present your nice object to your friends and they ask you, "But what is it for?" and you lose your nerves and say, "Hey man, it's art!" Just relax, you did it for you and you like it. Is it really art? I don't know, because I'm just a scientist formerly known as Nigeli.